What's up, y'all? My name is Don Surge, and I'll be going over how I use reference tracks to make some beats. So pretty much, story of this beat goes, I was in a producer slump. Like, I hadn't made beats probably for like a couple weeks now. And at that time, I was listening to some Bryson Tiller. So I figured to get out of my slump, I would use one of his songs as a reference track. So I started by going to Spotify, checking out his new album, Anniversary, listened to a couple of the tracks, see which one I liked best. And then I landed on Sorrows. Once I knew what track I wanted to use, went over to iTunes, bought the single track, so it was like $1.29, and then got to work. So I started off by finding the tempo of the track. So the way I do that is I just go online, search the song on Google, and actually usually give you the key and to give you the tempo. So if you're ever doing any remixes, it's a pretty good way to find both the tempo and the key. So let's go ahead and take a listen to the track first. So you can see it's a pretty dope track, and I have some kind of like locators here. So pretty much you see I have like an intro, verse one, bridge, verse two. So what I started off by doing is actually listening to the entire track and placing those locators when I realized it was kind of like a switch up in the track. So kind of understanding an arrangement. That way it would help me come up with an arrangement for my beat. So that's like kind of the foundation. So if I play each individual area, you'll notice that there's kind of different switch ups in the track. So there's your intro. First verse, bridge, another verse, bridge, and then the outro. So once I laid down the arrangement, while I was listening, I was also thinking, okay, what do I like about this track? I like the melodies, I like the drums, I like the 808, I like the whole thing. But me, I'm just trying to look to see, okay, what can get me started on making a beat. So what I really liked was the drum. I followed the exact same drum pattern. So the way I did that was I brought in audio for each individual sound. So you see I got kick, snare, and hi-hat. This rim shot I added myself later, but we'll go through that in a later process. If I listen to the beat, you can hear the drum pattern. Simple little kick and snare, but the hi-hat's a little bit complex. So I started off with the kick and snare. You can see I placed them where they needed to be. You can hear they're perfectly in sync. So I literally listened to the song, placed, okay, I hear a kick here, hear a kick there. I was slightly off, I would move it left and right until I was right on point. So now if I play them together, you notice that they're perfectly in sync. So when I hear the hi-hat, it's very low in the song, so I can't really hear how it is. So what I ended up doing is adding an EQ and completely just filtering off everything but the high end and boosting the crap out of the high end. And it's just so I can actually hear the hi-hats and the pattern. So if I play that, now you can hear the hi-hats a lot better. So when I played that, I pretty much tried making the same exact hi-hat pattern, and I just did it on the timeline. You can see I added the hi-hat sound that I liked and just try to mimic that hi-hat sound. So now if I play the two together, there's some correlation between them. So now you'll notice if I play all the drums together, it's very, very similar to the reference track. You'll notice they're pretty much in sync. So that pretty much gave me the foundation. I started just making the beat. So then I just mute the reference track and then get to work. I went to YouTube, looked up for hip hop samples, searched through a couple of them probably for like 15 minutes, found one that I liked, brought that sucker to Ableton. I ended up with this track called Pieces by Opa. So let's go ahead and take a listen to it. Kind of smooth vibe. And initially I had the entire track, listened to the entirety of it, decided what I liked the beginning, so I kept the beginning. Brought that sucker into simpler, and then went ahead and chopped it up. So I'm playing based off what I have with the drums. So if you play the drums and the chops that I did together, this is what you have. And you can see it doesn't really sound like the Bryson Tiller song, but the drums gave me a foundation to work on, and now I can continue making, kind of adding my own flavor to things, right? So I'm not trying to copy the song entirely. Sometimes it's good to copy the song entirely in regards to like sound design, arrangement, and your learning, and it does help you learn more. Like that hi-hat groove, I would have been able to actually come up with that on my own. So it kind of gave you the idea of, this sounds pretty dope, and see how that was made, and now you can go ahead and apply it. So it kind of gets you out of that creative rut sometimes, and that definitely helps me sometimes. And I'm actually trying to start using reference tracks more so that I can start learning, okay, oh, this is how they do this, this is how they do that. And I'm starting to get into sound design, so hopefully I can start using that for that as well. So once I had all that, I added the 808. So with all the elements, now I pretty much have my loop that I want to work with. And then once I have that loop, then I can work on arranging it. And guess what? I already got the arrangement. A good example here is this bridge. I got a big problem with transitions. I struggle the crap out of them. I always got to take a long time doing them. But having this arrangement kind of helped me. So in this case, if I listen to the reference track. Oh, oh, oh. I said I know when I'm saying page no more. You notice it's just like the melody. The hi-hat and the snare. So that's exactly what I did here. So now if I play the bridge, you'll notice it's just the hi-hat, snare, and melody. On the next verse, I want to switch it up a little bit with the drums. So I went ahead and added this rim shot. That's pretty much to add something new for the listener, right? So it's not just stagnant, it's always the same thing. Yes, the fundamentals are stagnant, but you add a little bit of ear candor here and there. So what I did is design a sound in Serum, process it a bit, add some distortion, some reverb, some delay, right? So more ear candy, introducing something new on the next verse. So now if we play it all together, that's what you got. That's pretty much it. You can see how reference tracks can kind of get you out of that creative block producer slump. I'm personally going to start using them more. It definitely helps me out. As you can see, I don't mimic it exactly the same in regards to the whole entire track. I kind of grab an idea here and an idea there, and then that way it guides me so I can make a beat that's original but yet has kind of the same flavor as the reference track. Also, you can use this in mixing. That's something that I'm trying to start doing. Still got a lot of work to do on the mixing end. So thanks for tuning in, and I'll see you in the next video. Peace.